couple different brands to dive into today. So first and foremost, One Size New Goodies. Makeup by Mario also blessed us with some of their products, and this is our first time trying this brand together. Big deal. Huda Beauty did release some new bomb brows. Milani has some new concealers, and ColourPop blessed us with a new collection. So I'm ready. But the question is, are y'all ready? Greetings and salutations. Hey girl, hey. What is up? As I told you guys, we got a lot to talk about today. But first and foremost, I wanted to introduce you guys to a brand I'm super familiar with, who was nice enough to bless us with a partnership today and help us keep the lights on. And today, that would be Schwarzkopf, which is the reason my hair is always popping. Let's be honest. Depending on how long you've been following me, you know, my hair's been colored for like a decade, girl. I love me some colored hair. I hop around the spectrum. I've hit almost every single color, and 90% of my colors are a blend of Schwarzkopf products. The poppin' pink, the really cute copper, my blondes, my browns, Schwarzkopf. This is all Schwarzkopf. And let me break down my hair for those who do ask me questions. I usually answer questions regarding my hair, typically on Instagram, but my YouTube peeps deserve an answer too, so this segment is for you. Of course, it's obvious I have short hair right now. I have a deeper brown base. It's quite faded, actually. I am due for an appointment very, very soon. We'll talk more about that later. But my natural root is to the top of my ears right now. And then I have lightened hair that we did tone darker. And I have my money piece, which is a little grown out, as you can see, that is blonde. And she goes down the sides of each side of my face. I currently wash my hair every 5 days because of my natural root. It does get flatter and greasier than when my hair is completely bleached. And usually I go about 7 days when it's in that condition. As far as frequency of salon visits, I go every 2 months roughly for a little trim, because short hair really needs that, as well as any toning to the blonde and to the base, because my hair will just lighten up between appointments between those 2 months. Anyone who has colored hair knows, every wash, you're gonna lose a little bit of color here and there, a little bit of tone, and you know, that's where the freshness goes. So what do we do between appointments? Some of us don't have the availability to go as often as we want. Sometimes I have to go a little longer than I want as well, and my hair naturally fades so brassy. I have Asian hair, black, dark hair, that will fade orangey, because naturally that's what happens with dark hair. Your orange hues come out, and when you have a blonde, which is yellow, it goes a little bit more brass, a little more copper, a little more penny. Not particularly something I enjoy. I like my blonde a little on the neutral side. Click cool. I usually start a little cooler when my hair is at the freshest point, because I know it's gonna warm up naturally. And this is where Schwarzkopf comes in with a $10 solution that is really changing the game, y'all. And this is available at our favorite place in the world, Target. Target. Yes, and I said $10. So let me introduce you to her. This is the Schwarzkopf Color Boost, Color Vibrancy Booster, available in multiple shades, which I will put on the screen right now. The shade I am currently holding and using is their Cool Blonde. Think of this product as a color booster that you mix in with your favorite conditioner. It's a color depositing drop that helps you tone the tones you want out of your hair and get it closer to what you want your hair to look like between your appointments. I use Cool Blonde because it helps neutralize the tones, because this is more of a blue shade in the bottle. Blue is opposite of orange on the color wheel. So the same way we use orange concealers on our under eyes to help counteract those blue purple tones under our eyes that make us look tired, this is the reverse. We're gonna use blue to help cancel out the orange tones that naturally come out of my lightened hair. They also include gloves in the box, so if you're worried about your nails or your fingers, you can definitely use the gloves. In the shower, I typically don't. That's just a me thing, but they give you 2 pairs, so you can, girl. Go ahead, use them. Of course, I have application footage for you guys, so you can check that out. If you need just a little boost in between your sessions, maybe just use 1, 2, 3 drops of this product. But if you're like me, I know my hair very, very well. She likes a lot. She's a bit extra. I'm more of a 5 to 6 drop gal, because whenever I use any sort of product in this family of, you know, depositing pigment, I do need a little bit more. I need towards the maximum size of the application directions. It's still in there. I need, you know, it's a little bit more. Just a little bit more than most people. And I know that to see results on my hair. So obviously take that as you will, use what you feel like you need. You leave this on for about 5 minutes and then you wash it out. So the fact that I can use a conditioner that I already know works for my hair was a huge plus for me when I was testing this out the whole month of February. My hair gets warmer at the top and even like the middle of my blonde, but as you guys can see, it does help tone some of that effect down, and it also is great for all hair types. It is ammonia free, peroxide free, also alcohol free, and for $10 you can get a couple uses out of this bottle. Like, it's a great bang for your buck. And the packaging, real simple but effective. I haven't had any staining issues, but of course I wanted to show you guys everything that was included in your options as far as application goes. If you're looking for an accessible hair color product to give you that little oomph, that little sprinkle between your hair color appointments, make you feel fresh again without breaking your bank, Schwarzkopf got you covered, girl. So you can head down to my info box, I'll have it linked off down below, or you can head to your local Target to pick this up for $10. The application you all saw was for my lash wash day, which was earlier this week, a couple days ago. I think she's still looking good. I mean, this is some fabulous bedhead, if I say so myself. She's pretty cute. But on the note of cute, our makeup's also cute, and we need to jump into this application because she got her headband on, looking a little bald headed. We got like this little doohickey bun going on back there. So let's get into the face, the beat, the glam. So I currently have L curl lashes. I'm gonna be trying M curls, which are the most like straight up ones next. They're just not in stock right now, so I decided to try an L curl, which is still a straighter lash, not as curly as you guys can see. It doesn't do like a curve, it's more like arrow like, which I kind of prefer. So these are pretty fresh still, and they are like super volume, so I'm still getting used to it. We're gonna work our way around those. The first thing I wanted to try today was these One Sizes Secure the Blur Hydrating Under Eye Patches. I've worn them once or twice before. It comes in a set of six like this. We're just gonna place these under our eyes and do our brows and our eye makeup and let these hydrate, blur, and prime our eyes. They're supposed to de-puff, reduce the appearance of our dark circles, smooth fine lines, and improve overall texture. You wear it for about 10 to 15 minutes. Will I be doing my eye makeup a little longer than that? Probably. But we're gonna put these on. It looks like gigantic pads that they usually put on when you get your eyelash extensions. These are just like the cuter version. Ooh. They're very soft. It just feels like a sheet mask compared to silicone. Trying to get them a little bit even out on my face. I actually realized recently, because my brow tech mentioned on her Instagram story that there's two centers of your face. There's the actual like center of your face, and there's like the center between your eyes. Because no matter what, one of your eyes is a little farther away from your nose than the other, typically, because you know, not everyone is symmetrical. More times than not, we're not. And this is when I really notice it. Stuff like this. This is my little one size pamphlet, as you can see. Patrick looking fabulous. The Patrick Star. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Serving us skin. We will be using the primer later when we get to the base. But again, brows gotta happen first. We're gonna slick the brows up using the Anastasia Brow Freeze, the clear brow styling wax. You gotta use a little bit of a wet brush. And you can see the little brush marks. You just grab just a little bit, and we're gonna slick my brows up. They're all over the place right now. I think I pulled my hoodie off my head and it was just like poof. And then seal them down. This is really lightweight. It's even more lightweight than soap. It is not as sticky as the majority of products on the market. Everyone's been loving it because it's just really, you know, lightweight in texture and doesn't give you like that soapy. Some soaps, you know, leave a little residue. It doesn't give you that residue. I typically don't have too much issue with soap residue unless I apply too much, and you guys know your girl is kind of heavy-handed. But we're just gonna slick the brows back. So you may notice my brows are fading more and more, because that's kind of the goal. It's been a year since I touched them up last. I touched them up last February, so they're due because I get them touched up once a year. The more I let it fade, the better the results will be when I touch it up, because it will give us more of a blank canvas for some fresh strokes. And I think it's still looking really good, so I'm happy with it, especially being that, you know, my brows are naturally in the oilier section of my forehead. And a lot of people, you know, don't recommend microblading for oily skin as much nowadays. They usually go powder brows. But I still love my microblading. Like, a year faded, she's still fly. What I don't love are these little stubborn brow areas. I have really, really, really coarse random strands at the bottom that don't like to do what they should. Slick on back, slick on up, snatched. For our brow pigment, I actually have new Huda Beauty. This is their Balm Brows. And I believe this is a micro shade brow pencil. I'm using shade medium brown today. I haven't tried it yet. We got, ooh, a spoolie. And then of course the actual product. Let's see how micro she really is. Oh my gosh. My camera is quite confused because this brow pencil is so skinty. It's a very lightweight brow pencil, like it's a lightweight plastic, and I kind of like the grip. I like the angles. It's giving me like a lot to hold on to. Some strokes where we need it, where we're a little bit more faded than not. This blends right into my microblading. Shades perfect. You never know when you pick a brown. It's actually quite scary how close it is. If you ever wanted to know what my brow color looks like in real life, it's this. And I've never really said that before, so wow. It is more of a fragile pencil. I just accidentally broke off a little piece. I'll be honest, I haven't really used too many brow pencils by itself lately. Like usually I have more of the ink 3 bristles, so I'm still kind of rusty on this, like actual, like more of like a solid background. I think that's it for now. If we need more brow later, we'll put some more brow later, but that doesn't bother me. So the cream of the crop today, we got a lot of Makeup by Mario, one of the palettes, which I'm really scared to open to assess the damage, and I think it's the one I really wanted to use, seems to have broken in mail, so find out together. I mean, it's not too bad. It's obviously the bronzy shade that I really wanted to use. Of course it would be, why wouldn't it be? But I think we can still salvage this for use and maybe just press that back together, clean it up, because only one shadow did have an issue. But let's look at the other palette, which I believe is totally fine. Here we are. More of a rosy glam, that's what it's called. It actually gives me like plum vibes. Mm-hmm. Though it's a little dirty from the other palette. Breaking, this is the Master Crystal Reflector. Ho 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 ho. I'm very excited for that. And then we do have the trio of glosses, and I was really honored to be put on this list. So thank you so much to the Makeup by Mario team for sending these goodies over. We got the lip palette, which we're probably gonna mix up some sort of beautiful concoction today. Mm-hmm. What are you guys feeling? I mean, with the eyeshadows we have, it seems like we need a bronzy look. Grabbing a little concealer to just put that under the brow, clean it up, and prime the eyelid. Okay, so my concealer has just revealed that I have a really bad dry spot right there, which I was unaware of, but I sometimes get little dry moments, and concealer highlighted it because I was using more of a matte or finish concealer. This is the Makeup Forever Matte Velvet Skin. I'm sure we can figure out a way around that later, but just to announce her presence. Doesn't seem like there's a highlight shade or even more of like a transition shade between these two. There are bigger palettes. I don't have those right now. I do have this new Bambi palette from ColourPop, and I think we're gonna have her assist using Little April Shower. This is actually like a warm yellowy shade, oddly enough. We're just gonna bring this up. That really looks good on my skin tone. I am not hating. It already looks like, wow, one shade in. A little bit of fallout, but overall not the worst thing I have tried. Any sort of brow grown shade you have. I'm just gonna grab this one from this palette and pack it on right above so we don't lose that. To me, that always makes everything look really nice and smooth, really nice and clean. I'm gonna swatch these shades, the metallic specifically, and try to carefully not make a huge mess. Those are the two lighter. And this one's really pretty too. It looks more green in the pan, but it's not too green on my skin tone. It looks way more limey. Oh, it fell out, the chunk fell out, as you guys can see. Unfortunately, I won't be holding that palette up anymore during the video, but I will press it back together and get you guys some B-roll, so you'll be able to see it when I mention it in hopefully a better state. Will it look brand new? No, but it will look better. So let me wipe up this. Whoa, I really had more faith than I should have that it wasn't gonna do that. But I like all three of the shades. What am I gonna do? I'm actually leaning that little green tone one. I think she's a little something special. So let's start packing that on. Just the lid. Kind of earthy. Very pigmented. It's my first time trying any of their products, so we're gonna get to know them together. That packed on beautifully. It's giving me earthy. It's giving me like Virgo. This is rich Virgo vibes. With a clean brush, I'm gonna blend out the edges and kind of just shape that eyelid. As you can see, this side softened up really nicely. With whatever's left from our crease brush, I'm also gonna put that there. I think just a little inner corner, outer corner moment. I think that's all we need. It's already like, this is cute already. I like it like that. But that's not much of a experiment for you guys. So into the dark matte shade, the one matte from this Bronze Glam. She's gonna go into our outer corner. I was just using more of a tapered brush and I kind of regret that. I feel like it was just a little big, at least the one I was using. Now into more of like a tapered pencil brush from Morphe. I'm just gonna lay this down at like an angle. This is really, really pigmented, as you can see. And as I'm trying to blend out the edges, I'm just laying more product down. So I do need to switch a brush. because there's just so much product, even from like a two tap, just a tap tap, and we need to blend. I'm gonna need a little assistance. So I'm gonna take Kind of Bashful from the Bambi palette, which is just a little lighter than the color we just laid down, and I'm gonna take it just a little bit on the tip of my brush and blend out that edges. Those edges, that edges, whatever. She's just talking today, it seems. It's really sticking interestingly on this eye. I don't know. Okay, so looks pretty good once you put in the elbow grease to blend. That pigmentation is not to be played with. Even though I was quite aware, it still took a little bit of effort and, you know, transition color, blending color, layer, layer, layer. What we got somewhere. I'm in debate to either take the darkest shade of the Bambi palette and just put it right here, or layer the color we already have and see if that just builds. I'm gonna try that. I'm gonna tap just a little and just kind of stamp it onto where I want it, close to the lash line, because this is more of like a tapered brush. Still giving a soft glam, so I'm not mad at it. I don't plan on doing liner because the lashes, I feel like, have already filled that spot. Just a little tap into the darkest Bambi shade, which is called White Tail. This has a little bit of sparkle in it. All right, guys, I'm pretty sure I'm happy with this. Yeah, yeah. It's a vibe. It's earthy. It's warm. It's going good with the brown eyes. I'm cool with it. This has definitely been over 10 to 15 minutes. But here we go. They're all dry now. We're just gonna tap whatever's left in. But the under eyes, she's prepped. She's hydrated. Perfect timing because now we can work on our base. We're gonna jump right into the primer, which is the One Size Secure the Blur Mattifying, Smoothing, Gripping Primer. So basically makes your makeup more long wearing. It's ultra blurring. We'll see how it goes. Let's look. Ooh, lots of control in that pump. It's like a silicone. I thought it was gonna be more liquidy, almost like a sunscreen, but I wonder if this is enough. I'm gonna put this around my larger pores, which is typically around my nose, as you guys can see. I'm actually gonna rub it in my problematic areas too, because why not? We wanna look flawless. I'm gonna put it more on this side of my face as well. I have this healing acne scar, as you can see right there. She's fresh. She's from this month's, you know, favorite week of the month. Sarcasm heavy, sarcasm extreme. This really goes on like a nice moisturizer. It doesn't feel super sticky. Doesn't feel super silicone-y either, like too gelatinous. And I can see a huge difference in my forehead already, just from the side that has the product, as you can see by it just reflecting on only one side of my face now. Wow. This would be great for, you know, makeup artists who are working on set and such and have to, you know, try to tame that glow. It's very skin-like, but it feels good on. I haven't actually picked out my foundation for today, but I do know I want to try these concealers. I saw this on one of my friends, Wes, and he looked amazing in it. We do have different skin tones though, but these are by Milani. It's their new Supercharged Brightening Under Eye Tints. I have peach and I have deep peach, which looks like a corrector on me. So we might use both, like an under eye correction situation. This has vitamin C, it has, of course, the PG10, caffeine in it, and also hyaluronic acid. So she might be really great. Only time shall tell. I'll take the lighter peach and put that under my eyes. I feel like I can smell something, but I don't know if I can. You can wear alone or underneath. It says 2-in-1 skincare makeup. We're gonna make sure this edge is nice and clean. So that was with the brush, kind of natural. Not really a huge difference. Let's try a little bit more. We're gonna use a sponge and then I'm also gonna bust out the deep peach shade. Formulation wise, as you can see, texture, it doesn't move that much. It's not super liquidy, but it does have like a gel feel to it, like a liquid gel. Grabbing my sponge of the day, packing that on. Bouncing, pouncing, spreading in place. Okay, what do you guys think? You can still see some things, I'm sure. We're gonna put on the deep peach, which may be better for me. That's giving me correction. That is canceling out tones. It's got a little more, so I'm gonna put it over my new acne scar and my dark spot that I have right here. And then whatever else I have left, we'll get just a little something. I'm not really in my summer shade, so I thought the lighter peach was gonna work for me, but I think it looks fine. I don't feel like we're really gonna get much out of the lighter peach, so we're just gonna use whatever was on the back of my hand and put it on the chin. Be a little down the center. For foundation, I just chose the Dior Forever 24-Hour High Performance Foundation. It's a really, really great long wear foundation. I don't think I did a separate review on it, unless I'm crazy, and I might have. Maybe last summer. I don't know. I just know I've used it before. Anyway, 3W is our shade. Since we're going there today, we might as well just go there and put this on. I'll pounce it on all over. So as you're watching this, I'm actually, probably I've already done it, but I'm changing my hair tomorrow. I wanna switch it up, do something a little different, but not super different. I don't know, I'm in a mood and a mode. I feel like it changes every month. Like I'm sure I'll be like pinky pastel for spring and you know, all about the lights and the brights, but for February slash March, I'm like in this like moody black and white vibes. As you can see, I got my nails in today, black and white. I'm into that like contrast, that just effect right now. I think it's simple, it's neutral, it serves its purpose. It hits every time, if you know what I mean. So I think I might do a split dye, and my appointment is the day after I film this. So by the time you're watching this, it's already been done and you've probably already seen it. You can go check out my Instagram, but I never know. Sometimes I'll back out before like actually making the decision. Like you never know until you get in the chair and you set that game plan. I always have a couple options in my head. The money piece was fun. It really was fun and it's hard to let it go, but I think we're gonna have a little bit more blonde on one side, it seems. At least for a month or two, likely two. I also put a little faux tan Sam moment going on, so that's why the shade is gonna match. I'm like hitting my throat. Shade is gonna match totally fine because your girl was getting pasty and like pasty to the point that I was not enjoying it. I was like, who is that in the mirror? Like, whoa, you know, like my face was just getting way too pale, especially my body started fading. When my shoulders and stuff start fading, I know I need a little round of, you know, spray water tan in the bathroom. And it always comes out just like I would look the rest of the year. So beautiful, gorgeous, laid, soft. But we're a little one-dimensional, so we're gonna brighten up since we corrected under the foundation. This is the Pretty Fresh Concealer from ColourPop. This, I know for sure, has its own review. We do that and just kind of just notch thy face upward. I don't think I'm feeling blush today. Maybe just contour and highlight. That might be the vibe. I feel like I just cut into my like eyeshadow a little bit. There's this one hair that is just asking to get pulled out because it won't mind its business and, you know, stay back there. Yeah, we got a little high into the eyeshadow. Okay, I touched up what I could. I think we also lost just a little bit of eyebrow on this side with our concealer. Happens to the best of us. All right, a little touched up, a little fabulous. Okay. Contouring with a little bit of Colab. This is great for like shape, if you know what I mean. Gonna lightly put this down my nose. She's gonna look a little crazy until I, you know, get my highlight powder, but I'm gonna apply the bronzer. Of course, my scar is right where I need to apply my contour today. Of course it is. Why wouldn't it be? I feel like we're applying our bronzers higher and higher every year. At this point, it's gonna be our crease color. But I see the point. I'm not sure if I've fully adapted to it yet. Not everything works for everybody, but here we are. All that double chin action. A little bit of my Colab loose powder, and that's for our under eyes. Really nice, really brightening. Whoa, can't get enough of that. Kind of got away from me for a second, but it's okay, it's okay. A little bit of our pressed highlight powder just down the center. Now for the fun of the Master Crystal Reflector. Okay, so this is in quartz. I believe there's another shade as well, but this is just like the clearer, sparkly. I think there's a gold maybe, but ooh. This gives you like really fine, not chunky, blendable sparkle. So maybe kind of just around this area for like a moment, a temple moment. It doesn't really feel like anything when you're not rubbing it. When you're rubbing the pan, you can feel a little more grip, but then when you like just press it around, kind of does this thing. I see a lot of people using this for their eyes, so we're gonna try with our pinky and just press it around. Ooh, and then a lot of people like go up higher, you know, like kind of in that little poquito. Ooh, I mean, it's not for everyone, and I think the gold one would look better with the shade, but you see what I'm saying? You hear the message? We're the gals who want that reflex without the mess, without the stickiness. Just kind of just going all over at this point. Like we're going there, you know? Yeah, it's like money, that's money. Okay. So in the lightest shade of the bronze, oh my God, I can't open it right now. Bronze palette is gonna go into our inner corner. There she is, oh goodness. It's really pretty. It's like a goldy champagne, Okay, I think a little lower lash line work. We'll take the darkest shade of the Mario palette and just work it into the outer corner. You blend. So it's gonna hug really nicely and give kind of that like drop shadow effect. And just that one color, when you drag it around, it kind of gives you a natural gradient in a way. So here we go. Last but not least, we're gonna work on the lips. I think that's gonna be the funnest part for us. Still a little dewy setting spray just to get our skin just looking nice and blended and right. This is the Fenty Beauty What It Do spray. I like living it. It's basically my blood type. Here we are, the Master Mattes Pro Lip Palette. It's numbered. It has like LP through 12 and then P1 through B4, which I believe, yep, it's the mixer shade. Comes with this little mixing tray, and then the colors behind it, yellow, blue, white, and black. White makes colors lighter, black makes them darker, yellow makes them warmer, blue makes them cool. So you can really customize the color you want with these shades. Something's a little too pinky, you can always add a little yellow, etc., etc. It comes with a double-ended brush. It's kind of like a spatula brush. It looks like this. So you got your actual applicator, and then you got this part that can help you mix on the tray. All right, so I don't think I'm gonna be lightening anything right away, so I'm gonna keep the palette closed. I kind of want to mess with the top row of shades. I'm gonna take a little bit of L4 out, put that on the palette, wiped off the stick, and then grabbing a little bit of L1 and putting that there. Let's see what they just look like straight up on me. L4. Yeah, that's not what I'm going for. So maybe a little L3. That's a little different. Once again, I don't think that's what I'm going for. So let's try L1. Okay, so she's like nude and it feels quite spreadable. I think this would be really cute on top of a lip liner of some sort. So I packed the majority of the product on the inner part of my lip because I want to use a darker shade around it. I think I'm gonna grab L6. Put that around. That's kind of cute. So that would be L6. We'll just put that without needing to do all that craziness. Put this one first. It feels so lightweight. One of the better lip palettes I've ever tried, because back in the day they used to feel heavy and dry at the same time. And the brush is a really good brush. It's long, it's flexible, it gives you a lot of flat space to blend with and apply with. Even all this layering over my natural dries, crap lips, it's still looking good. So this is basically almost an all over L6. I'm gonna take some of L1 and mix a little yellow into it. She's gonna get a little adventurous. She's gonna make it a little warm. These aren't super matte. They're like on more of a, just like a satin. It's like a satin, yeah. So let's throw a gloss on. We have three glosses as mentioned earlier. From the top, Make It Drop, Golden Nude, Mauve Nude, Rose Nude. Right here. Of course, we golden. We real golden here. So we're gonna give that a go. Okay. Typical, flexible, large doe foot. Oh yeah. I think if you take L1, mix it with a little yellow, and then mix it with a little white, it would give you a really nice dimensional, like almost like a 90s lip on top of L6. But this goes. This really hits. It's not sticky, really smooth. This reminds me a lot of, God, I forgot what it was called. It was a MAC lip gloss, a lip glass specifically. And it was like a peach with sparkles in it. And I can't remember what it was called, but it was like everyone had it. I had it, I loved it. Go to. It's not Peach Stock, that's the lipstick. But if you know what it is, definitely comment it down below. I think we're gonna put just a little bit of lower lash line mascara. I think that's our look for the day. We do also have the one size eyeliner. I don't feel like we needed that with the current, you know, lash situation. Yeah, that was that. I didn't expect too much out of everything. I didn't really know actually what to expect, but I'm pleasantly surprised with everything we tried today. Just some sum up thoughts for the primer. I definitely see more of a matte look. My pores are definitely less visible. So if you're looking for something that helps with those areas, as well as gives more of that like matte finish to begin with, this definitely gave that effect immediately. So you'll really like that. As far as the concealers, I think I like the darker one better than the lighter one. And its consistency isn't bad, but I wouldn't say it has a lot of coverage. But if you're just starting to tiptoe into color correcting, or you feel like you need something to help with any sort of purple or blue tones that are underneath your eyes, and something affordable, then the Deep Peach from Milani is not a bad formulation. Brow pencil, shade again, perfect. I think it is very fragile though, so keep that in mind. If you're a little heavy-handed like me, you might break off a chunk here and there, and it is, you know, on the smaller side. But overall, no real complaints about this balm brow. I agree, it's pretty balm, and I will definitely be using it in the future, so not much to say there. Mario-wise, we touched base a lot, so pigment for the price, for sure. I like the aesthetic. It's very simple, it's clean. It's giving you like makeup artists, you know, but bougie. Give me those high quality vibes, shall I say. I think the lip palette is well done. I obviously haven't even opened the mirror, but you get a really large mirror there. And for something that's sealed without like a film over it, it doesn't seem to be dry at all. My lips feel great. The glosses, of course, make it look even better, really blends everything really nicely. And I think all three shades would be something I could totally rock because of the amount of shimmer in it. It doesn't make my lips look shimmery. It looks more shimmery in the container, but they're very, very, very comfortable and they really give you that like smooth, reflective look. Bambi really came through. So if you're in debate on this new palette as well as the collection, I do have other things from the collection. I really like the shades. I'll definitely be dipping into it. It's the perfect size for that like assistant sous chef type of palette. For our under eye patches today, they definitely hydrate, and that's what they mainly claim to do. They are hydrating under eye patches that are supposed to help blur and prime and, you know, reduce the appearance of puffy circles, dark circles, etc. I don't think this is a, oh my god, huge difference, but if you want something comfortable that you can easily do your makeup around and not have like dry looking concealer, if you feel like your under eyes look drier than they used to, then something like this would be great for that. If you don't use an eye cream like immediately before doing your makeup like I do, then this would help assist that. I think that's it for today, guys. I don't want to put any grades on anything because it's really just first impressions, and I think our summary gave you guys my opinion pretty well. So thank you so much for watching and vibing and just chilling with me. I appreciate it so much. Don't forget, if you are looking for an affordable hair treatment that helps you keep your color looking great between sessions and appointments, Schwarzkopf got you covered at Target, yes, Target, for $9.99, and I will have it linked off down below as well. That's it for today, guys. My recent uploads are gonna be on the screen right now for you guys to clicky-clicky and enjoy, as well as the subscribe button, which is free $99. You can hit that if you haven't yet to join our fam. That is it. I've said enough. I've said my piece. Don't forget to like this video to support the channel, and I'll see you guys in a later one.